In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this spiral staircase with arrays. I'll use a previously created mesh as a reference, to match the settings while modeling a new mesh. Let's create a cylinder. Type, G, Z, and, 1, to align the mesh's bottom face with the world center. Let's make sure the origin is set to the 3D cursor. S, to scale, and, S, and, Z, to scale on the, Z, axis. I'll match the previously created mesh's scale values. Let's create a cube, and scale it. Let's go to the front viewport, and scale the cube like this. G and X to move on the X axis. S, and, Y, to scale on the, Y, axis. Let's add the array modifier. Please match my settings. We need to create a new empty object for object offset. When this, or any other odd issue occurs after adding array, please press Ctrl, A, to reset all transforms. Let's create a cylinder and scale it. Let's add the array modifier for this cylinder as well. We can use the same empty object as the object offset object. Let's press Shift, A, to create a spiral. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. My Blender unexpectedly crashed while I was working on this spiral curve. As you can see, I didn't save the file frequently enough, and ended up losing everything I've worked so far. I was going to tell not to move the curve like this, because there's a location category that we can use below. I moved the curve manually, and I was going to show there's no way to edit the values by right-clicking the curve. I was wondering what this offset curve was, and when I clicked it, my Blender crashed. Please save your work frequently. I tried to recover what should have auto-saved periodically, but failed. This was the prototype mesh I have worked on, and this was the only file that I could find. I'll just model the mesh again, and turn on the time compression. I'll get to the spiral part shortly. The time compression ends here. Alright, let's work on the spiral curve. After matching the radius, we need to increase the Z location to move the curve up like this. After adding turns, please make sure the upper part looks okay as well. The turn only adds the same curve again on the Z axis, so if the curve's measurement was wrong, this issue would occur. When a mistake is made while using the curve spiral, just delete it and create a new spiral. The previous settings will show up right away. There we go. Please check again from all angles. Let's bevel the curve. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.